Remember, there are 59,999,999 possible listeners to this programme. That's poor old Tommy. What a state. Right, back to the telephones. We're talking to Alison in Cheshire. Hello, Alison.
Hello there, Scotty. How are you?
How are you? I'm the better for hearing you, I can tell you that.
I'll tell you something, it's chucking it down here. Absolutely horrible.
Tell me this, have you had beautiful weather? I saw on the news that the northwest was catching the old rain.
Well, we had gorgeous weather up to about 8 o'clock last night.
Right.
And the heavens opened and I don't think we've stopped ever since.
Oh my God, what part of Cheshire are you in?
South Cheshire, near the Staffordshire border.
I know exactly where you are. I passed you last week.
Oh, you didn't,
yes.
Did you?
Are you near Leek?
Yeah, I'm about, about 10 miles away from Leek.
10 miles from Leek, and are you enjoying the new megaphoning?
Yeah, I mean, to be honest, I don't get much time to listen.
Well, you need to make time.
I usually listen in the car, and I trundle along and listen away.
But you need to make time, Alison. I'll give you a note if it's for a third party. I'll give you a note to say... Alison must be excused boots to listen to Scotty McCrew's national megaphoning.
Yeah, I'm going to tune my radio at home to you
as
well.
Yes, you must do all that and tell all your neighbours and your friends and say, look, we've all got to get our act together. This programme goes out from Monday to Friday and we must all listen in Staffordshire and South Cheshire.
Yes, I'll do that. But it's good talk to you anyway, having heard you a few times.
Yes, I know that. You'll remember me at one or two of the bygone stations.
Probably, yes.
Yes, you used to listen to the megaphone and that. You know, I mean, it's a sort of way of life, this programme.
Yes, I believe so.
It's not a minority programme, it's a way of life.
Yeah, it's got a bit of a cult following.
It's a bit of a cult following, yes.
My brother's heard you before, but I sort of stumbled across you sort of thing.
You did, love.
When you first started on National,
yes,
I stumbled across you.
You stumbled across and you said, what on earth is this?
Yeah, I thought, who's this crazy Scotsman?
What's this crazy man doing on our wireless?
But then I actually enjoyed it. So
yes,
there you are.
It's an acquired taste, you see.
Yeah, I feel sorry for the guy that decided he didn't want to do it anymore.
Yeah, he's got a serious problem actually, Tom, but not to worry. I mean, there's plenty of medical help out there for these people.
Well, there is, yeah, bless him.
He was saying, how can you have 60 million listeners? So we've got one less now.
Oh, well, one.
We can spare one. We can afford to chuck them away at that.
Well, it gives you a little bit more time to chat with the others, doesn't it?
I think so, yes. If we can get rid of some of the rubbish, we can get the quality on, you see. That's what it's all about. Weed out the rubbish.
That's it. That's how it works. Yes, it sounds great.
Well, you give my love to South Cheshire because it's a very lovely part of the world.
Certainly will.
Yes.
I certainly will. I just wanted to
I just can't afford to live there, that's all.
Well, I can't really. I mean, I moved here when I was born in the Potteries.
Oh, right, love. That's a bit warm, was it not?
It was a little bit, yeah.
Yes. What, in the cooling towers?
I was close there, yeah.
I was born in the Potteries.
Yeah, so I was born down there in sort of like Stoke-on-Trent.
I wasn't so much conceived, I was thrown on the wheel.
That's the one, yeah. Yes. I wasn't brought up, I was dragged up.
you weren't born, you were knitted.
That's the one, yeah. Yeah. But we moved here when I was about 4, so...
Brilliant.
You know, crisis then.
Yeah.
Our house was about £200, I think.
Oh, yes, yes.
And we're only...
It's two million now.
No.
2 million. Oh, no, sorry, the end terrace is 2 million, that's right. Yes,
if we're in end terrace, yeah, it's not 2 million,
it's not, if you're one in, that's right, then it's 1 million.
no, seriously, what I wanted to do was about marriage.
Right.
I actually think that divorce is made too easy.
I do.
I really, really do. I mean, I'm not married myself, I'm single.
Yeah.
And I'm only single purely from the point of view that I haven't got time to look for a man.
Well, save yourself for me.
Oh, okay then.
That'll be fine. Just look after yourself. And
I will do. I mean, I was saying to the guy that answered the phone that I'm self-employed.
We'll get together over a bag of chips.
Why not? Or a vanilla slice, even.
Well, you should be employed at McClue's Pies.
Is that what it is?
Oh, yes, we do a vegetarian lattice slice in a chicken sauce.
Right.
We do steak and kidney, and and we tried a tripe and onion pasty, but it was too windy.
Well, like a baked bean and sausage.
We're getting very good reports. So that was it. People said, just watch that doesn't backfire on you.
Yes.
So that was it. So the tripe and onion had to go by the by.
Yeah, it was like the trumpet voluntary at 20 paces.
Absolutely. You had to, you sort of didn't so much have to walk up the road, you got blown home.
It's quite all right if you've had a night in the pub.
Yes, people said I had to pay the bus fare back to my work after I'd had my pasty at lunch.
I used to
actually drive the baker's van, you see, and then one morning at 6 a.m, in a winter's morning, we used to crank the old van over, and I had them, and I had a cloud of diesel there, and I put a load of apple tarts with foil wrappers through the old alarm.
Yeah.
Through the metal detector.
Oh, man.
What a racket. So what's done in this town? And apple tarts! Oh, come on, for heaven's sake!
Yeah.
You know, I don't think it was heavens they said, it was something else, I can't remember.
Something that's quite unrepeatable.
Oh, absolutely.
If you could remember it.
If I could remember it and all the rest of it, you had to put it out of your mind, you see? You knew fine it was going to be repeated 5 minutes later. And we had an old boy with bad feet, and I said to him one day, have you got any more pies? And he went, no, I've got to make some more.
Oh, bless. It's a shame, isn't it?
Oh, they're brilliant.
It's a hard life, you know, being a baker.
It is.
That's why I'm single.
It's harder being a master baker. Careful how you say that.
Yes.
I
haven't quite reached that.
That, absolutely.
But I'm almost there. I've got 20 years experience, so...
You can always tell the master bakers because they're on more dough.
Yeah, and they've got smiles on the faces.
They've got smiles on their faces. And they go, what's this? And she go, an iced cat! And they go, get it in the bin.
Oh, let's be serious.
Sorry, love, I beg your pardon.
It's quite all right. No, it's no problem.
I'll wipe the smile off my face as we speak.
No, don't do that, because you sound a smiley person. No, seriously, back to marriage and divorce and all that.
Yes.
I really think it's made too easy.
Right.
Just from the point of view of people tend to go, a lot of people that, I mean, I've got friends that have gone into marriages.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, they've been all lovey-dovey and they've loved the person that they're going to marry. But they've always gone into it with the, oh, well, if it doesn't work out, we can get divorced.
Yes.
Whereas at one time, and this is from experience from my parent, at one time, divorce wasn't as easy.
Right.
And my mum and dad...
They put a bit more work into it.
Yeah, my mum and dad actually, I mean... I was born out of wedlock, and my brother was.
Right.
And it wasn't until, like, recently filling in pension forms and stuff like that, because I tend to do all the filling in, that I found
that's
this
your,
out.
That's your baker's training.
Well, it is, it must be. I'm crazy. and I only found this out, like, recently.
Right.
In the last
joking apart, did that shock you a bit?
It did a little bit, but it didn't. Because my mum and dad have always been pretty liberal in the thinking, you know
what
I mean?
Right, right. Which is not unhealthy in its own way, you know?
No. But they've always been man and wife.
Right,
as it were,
right.
You know, but the reason why they didn't marry until 10 years after I was born was because my mum had been married before.
Well, I thought they wanted to see what you looked like at 10.
Probably, yeah. It's a shame it was.
Get on.
When my dad saw me in the hospital, he says, goodness me, surely there's been a mistake.
Well, with me, the doctor slapped me dad.
So there you go. Oh, surely not.
Where did we get to? Right, go on.
Oh, yeah. Mum and Dad married 10 years after I was born.
Right.
And that the only reason was, my mum had been married before.
Yes.
And no matter what she did, the guy refused to give her a divorce. And he was a really nasty piece of work.
Right.
And I've met him since.
Yes.
And he really is a nasty piece of work.
And has that put you off marriage?
No.
No.
No, I just wish I could find a man that would cope with my stupid working hours.
Just nobody's asked you.
No. No, I mean,
do you have to get
married.
Do you have to get up at 2 a.m. then?
No, not quite that, about 4:30.
Oh, 4:30, oh yes. Just a, that's a late start.
It is a late start, it's a bit of a lie-in really.
Yeah, you got a good lie-in, don't you? Gotta lie-in today till about 3:45.
Yeah, yeah. And then I work till about 4:30 in the afternoon as well.
For heaven's sake, lass. Yes, yes, hard work, hard work.
It is.
Never mind, it's the same as the broadcasting.
Yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, I'm working, I'm not sort of taking money off the state or anything
you
like that.
You are not. You're a credit. You're a credit.
I'm contributing to the state.
You are, love. You're contributing to all these single mothers.
Bless Hector, the Inland Revenue Man.
Hector, yes. Bless him.
Well, you know what Hector means,
there's,
don't you?
There's a new one. Go on.
You know the little man with the bowler hat?
Yes, absolutely. I know him personally, yes.
Yeah, Hector. Well, Hector means to bully.
Well, to Hector somebody.
Yeah?
Of course it does, that's right.
Oh, I think it's great,
stop,
I do.
Stop hectoring me.
Yeah, somebody had a really good sense of humour when they named him.
They certainly did. You're spot on. Listen, I'm going to Dash. Take great care of yourself.
I was
going
to say, I'm going to have to go, you know?
Yeah, but save
yourself. Good chatting with
it's
you.
It's been lovely talk. Save yourself for me. You and I will get a 2 up, 2 down. And all that stuff and a bag of chips and a bottle of dandelion and burdock. Now, here we go.
Definitely. You take care and I'll talk to you soon.
Many blessings. See you, Alison.
Bye-bye now.
Bye, lovey. Bye.
Bye.
Bye now. What a sweet lady. Right, there you are. A female baker. What I've been looking for all my life. And give us a call as soon as you possibly can. We're discussing marriage, the ins and outs of it. Exceptionally busy, but try again. 2 Scotty McClure's National Megaphone in. Back with you after this.
More controversial than ever before, Scotty McClure's National Megaphone In, and it's back on air in seconds.